Hey guys, I'm Wenchfaery and welcome back to Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2, The Sith Lords. We are here in what the map calls the Secret Academy. Notice it's just Melon. Kreia and Atten have been taken prisoner by these Jedi. This is a secret Jedi school under the crust, under the surface, I guess, of Telos. The lady who runs it, Atris, was part of the Jedi Council when I stopped being a Jedi. By stopping a Jedi, I basically said, screw you all. If you don't want to help, I'm not going to be a Jedi. And that's what it comes down to.
Why have you approached me?
Just want to see if these people will talk to me. Oh yeah, where are my friends?
You will find them in the main irrigation channel room in the northern part of the plateau interior.
Okay.
With particle emitters there that once governed the flow of water to Telos can double as force cages.
I see. So they're prisoners.
They were caged for their safety until we could determine your intent, Exile. Atris cautioned.
And everybody in here is going to call me Exile.
Your allies would create a distraction. Your companions gave us little trouble, however. The male could have presented some challenge if he had resisted, but he chose not to.
I mean, you didn't put me in jail. Should I be flattered or insulted?
We have some training in dealing with Jedi. You would have posed little threat.
But Atten would have... I wouldn't have been a threat, but Atten would have been a threat.
He has had some Ichani training. He masks it well, but when you are in danger...
Huh.
His mask...
Ichani training, huh?
We know well.
I suppose I could muse out loud, because I know they're not going to tell me where he would have gotten that training.
I do not know. The Ichani forms are known to be taught to military special forces throughout the galaxy. If the source is a mystery to you, perhaps you should ask him. It would be wise to know those who travel
with. I mean, I might just have to do that. Where is my ship?
Your ship is stored in the hangar. Atris has given you permission to leave this place, and permission to return if you remain in her service.
I don't know how I feel about being in her service. She obviously doesn't think that I have changed at all, so...
You may ask...
Some questions about Atris.
The mistress? What of her?
I don't know. I'm going to ask both of these. Where
She's
is she?
She's meditating, and she does not wish to be disturbed. Your presence here has troubled her, and I hope you do not choose to trouble her further.
What can you tell me about Atris?
She leads us. As she rebuilds Telos, she rebuilds the Order, and through them, the galaxy.
How does she plan to do that? Because, like, last I heard, all the Jedi had been wiped out.
We serve the Jedi. We do not question them. Yet, Atris has told us that the work here at Telos may pay for similar efforts in many worlds along the rim that were destroyed when the Jedi turned on each other.
Oh, I see.
She has said the Jedi Order needs such a foundation if it is to rebuild. She faults the teaching of many of the Jedi Masters as the spark of the Jedi Civil War.
Does she now?
That if Revan and Malak had been properly instructed in the ways of the Jedi, they never would have fallen, and nor would you, Exile.
Yeah. What does she consider proper training, then?
That is unknown to me. I have never observed Atris to teach Jedi, nor would I wish to. Atris has chosen instead to focus her efforts on galactic recovery. Once the galaxy breathes again, disciples will come.
Uh-huh. Yeah, she'll need help if she tries. She knows nothing about training Jedi. We know from the last prompt that she never even had a Padawan, so...
She predicted you would say as much. She seems to know you quite well. Perhaps you are the one who knows nothing.
You know nothing, Jon Snow. Jon Snow. I had some other questions.
You may ask.
Tell me about this place.
This was once a mighty irrigation center for Telos. It survived the orbital bombardment of the Sith... Though the inhabitants did not. Ancient irrigation channels still lie beneath the surface of Telos, waiting to be used again for the reconstruction efforts controlled from this facility.
Okay, so I know what this is. Why are you guys here?
Shortly before the destruction of Dantooine by the forces of the traitor Jedi Malak, Atris had many Jedi artifacts and knowledge transported here secretly.
You stole stuff. Yeah, how did she know Dantooine would be destroyed?
The Jedi Council sensed it. Master Vruk, Master Vandar, but it was too late to do much except Master make Vrug arrangements for evacuation.
Listen, Master Vrug, the guy wasn't very nice to me.
It was a dark day for the Order. Many on Dantooine did not survive, Jedi or not. Atris would not speak for many days after the attack, and we feared our mistress was lost to us. In time, she regained her voice and her strength. She brought the artifacts and the teachings of the Jedi here and has kept them safe.
Okay, why were they brought here and not somewhere else?
Even the Sith prefer live prey to scavenging a corpse.
She okay, well, you know what? I agree with her there, as much as it pains me to say it.
A second time. It was a place where the artifacts and the teachings of the Jedi could be kept safely if the Sith could not be turned aside.
What kind of artifacts did you steal? Yes, I mean, relics from take here.
Some which predate even the destruction of Ossus. She was not able to save all. But she saved enough. She was able to bring them here before the Academy's destruction. It was a fortunate thing. She was not able to save everything.
Can I... Oh no, what's Ossus? Let's answer my honest question first.
Ossus was once the home of much of the Jedi teaching and knowledge. It was destroyed over 40 years ago by the Sith, during the time of Exar Kun. Fortunately, a few relics and artifacts were saved before Ossus was destroyed. But many were not.
Yeah, I don't remember that. I would like to see some of the Jedi knowledge.
Viewing the relics is not allowed without Atris's permission.
Then I'll have to go get her permission. Yeah, if I get permission, will you allow it?
I exist to serve the Jedi.
That's kind of creepy.
You may
other
ask,
questions. What do you do here?
We serve the Jedi, and we watch.
Serve what Jedi?
Atris is the only
like...
Jedi here. This is true. But the mistress will bring others in time.
I mean, I'm here too, but whatever. I don't identify as a Jedi at the moment, so we're okay. Are you in training to become a Jedi?
I assume you meant no insult. It is forbidden for us to become Jedi. Even if we possessed the awareness of the galaxy that the Jedi possess, we are here because we are not Jedi. That is our purpose.
I didn't mean it as an insult, sorry.
We have taken an oath to never follow the teachings of the Jedi, only to watch those of the Order.
Does that mean you're,
carry out
like,
Atris's will should
okay
it be
to be
necessary.
Sith, then?
Atris believes the new Jedi Order that shall arise here will need to be guarded and watched by those not touched by the Force. She thinks it will give balance.
Other questions?
You may ask...
Elephant in the room here. Why do all of you look the same?
We share the same father, and we all bear the face of our mother. It is not unusual for the Achani of the same parents to be born so as to be indistinguishable to outsiders.
The one handmaiden who challenged us when we arrived, she looks different. Oh, I don't know who that is, but okay.
As I have said, it is not unusual for the Achani of the same parents to be born so as to be indistinguishable to outsiders.
That's not much of an answer.
If you seek to raise anger in me, you will fail, Exile. I tolerate your presence only upon orders of the Mistress. She did not order me to endure your questions.
I mean, I wasn't trying to offend you.
One cannot take back an action, and often apologizing for it only compounds the insult. Simply drop the matter and be silent.
Let me ask you something else.
Ask?
Now, you know what? I don't want to ask any of those things.
Why have you approached me?
Are you going to be the same person? Yeah, never mind. Same thing. So let's look around. We're here. Atris has decided that the Jedi will need to be guarded by non-Jedi. I mean, I'm not sure I agree with her there. I guess I can kind of see where she's coming from, because the Jedi do tend to get up their own butts a bit about things, but I don't really agree with her 100%. Oh, nah. Oh! This is my droid! Yeah, they didn't memory wipe you, did they? Yeah. It wasn't your fault. They took the ship, T3. You're just a little utility droid. It's okay. It's the TSF's fault they took the ship. Hold on. Wait, she downloaded what from you? Downloaded information? Oh, fuck. Atris, for real? Yeah, where did she download it to? Point. And I will go read it. Let's get you back to the ship and then we can talk more. Yeah, we'll see you at the Ebon Hawk. Go. Oh, hey, light side points. Because I was nice to my little robot friend. Workbench. Oh, plus steel cylinder. I do want to make some, There it is! There it is! That's a door, but I'm checking all these consoles first. No, huh? Alright. What's in here? A hallway. What's down this hallway? The Ebon Hawk. And a plasteel cylinder. Okay, so we found our way to the ship. We're not leaving Kraya, Atten, and Beodor behind, though. So. I do want to make a couple med packs. Do we have any broken things I can break down? No. I can make advanced ones, too. There. Oop. Nope. Nope. Okay. All right. So I want to talk to everybody we can without, like, getting ourselves murdered.
Why have you approached me?
Same questions? No. Never mind. I'll be going now. I don't really want to talk to them and hear the same thing over and over again. Oh, found a friend. Oh, what happened?
What you came for?
I mean, not yet. No. Yeah, a woman from my past has made this place her home. I did not expect to see her again.
I felt as much. Quite strongly, in fact. I suspected there was something from your past here, something unresolved. I feel we did not come to this place by chance.
Kraya, we didn't even know there was a here.
This woman who resides here, she did something to you once. Something that hangs upon you still.
I mean, she was part of the council when they kicked me out, pretty much.
I see it now.
Yeah.
The act has left its mark.
I mean, I'll give you that.
Be warned. Unresolved events from our past can create wounds in the present and the future. And more importantly, they can distract you, weaken you. It could prove fatal.
Well, she does have my lightsaber.
We face.
Yeah, I mean, she's a Jedi.
There is a Jedi here, perhaps, in that you are correct. Yet there are no students. And this woman, this Atris, surrounds herself with those who cannot feel the Force. Curious.
No, I knew that. Yeah, she plans to fix the galaxy and then the Jedi Order, actually.
Lands are fragile things, and life often dashes expectations to the ground.
Isn't that
perhaps
true?
Students will come to her in time. For now, she is surrounded by those who cannot feel the Force.
Well, she's done that on purpose, though. Yeah, they can't.
Yes, her servants are not Jedi. Their minds are walls trained to resist tricks of the mind.
Okay,
this
that much we didn't
blinds
know.
Blinds them to the Force as well, even if they were Force-sensitive.
Were you trying to use Jedi mind tricks on them?
Invade the mind of another? It is not something done carelessly, or when there is nothing to be gained.
I mean, we can talk about it on the way out.
Very
Let's
well.
Go.
Let us depart.
What even happened to Atten?
He's only sleeping. It seems the journey here has fatigued him.
I'll shut down the cells and get you out of there.
I'm sorry, General.
Oh!
I've lost consciousness in the crash.
That's okay, Beodor. Are you all right?
I'm fine, General. Even power has been restored to my arm. What is this place? Where are we?
It's a weird Jedi place. It's fine.
This must be where I had detected the energy readings before. And the
no kidding, Beodor! For reals?
This place? It looks part of a huge polar irrigation system. Possibly planet-wide. Like the one on Coruscant. I had been told by the Republic that it was not in use.
I mean, it's not really. Are you well enough to travel?
I am, General. If you wish, I may travel with you or join you at the ship.
You can join me at the ship. Meet me at the ship and prep for launch. We're leaving as soon as we can.
I will await your arrival.
Yes. Yes, I'm aware.
Hey. You're back with us. We were just on our way to rescue you from those ghost women when, we got locked up.
Yeah, I mean, are you all right? Like...
Don't worry about me. I'm fine. How did things go with the Jedi here? Are you all done?
I mean, not... Yeah, not quite. Yeah, I've agreed to help them.
Well, that's not exactly what I wanted to hear.
I mean, you can leave if you want to.
No, I was just complaining. I'm with you until things start going better for you. We need to stick together, you know? And who knows? I might be able to help you out of a tight spot at some point.
Oh, well. Thanks, Atten. That's cool of you.
Don't mention it.
Even though you are being pleasure. Emotionally manipulated by Kreia, I don't know that. We need to get moving. Kreia.
Let us keep moving.
Okay. We'll explore a little longer, then we can go. We're gonna find Atris again. I also would like to find the console she downloaded T3M4 onto. Well, this is a fighting room. Last steel cylinder! You know what? Let's look here, just to be sure. Oh, they sleep on the floor. Bet you that's cold. Like, they're underground, like the frozen north. This can be, like, the coziest, most hospitable place in the world. Oh,
I hear you.
Can you please unlock this? I would like to open it. Thank you. Some components. That handmaiden over there just does not care that I'm going into people's bedrooms and taking their stuff. Everything is so Spartan. They're not allowed to have things either. They're not allowed to feel the force. They're not allowed to be Spartan. They're not allowed to have stuff. All right, let's get out of this room. One more room.
I hear you.
Don't get stuck on Kreia then. It's so easy. Back to me. Let's check the map. Oops, that's not the map. This is the map. Okay, so that's the Ebon Hawk. We want to go this way. That'll be Atris. Now that I have Atten and Kreia with me, this may not go well. But I mean, I guess we'll see. What if they'll stop me? Nope. Oh, look at her. She looks like she's... She was trying to look like she has a Jedi Council and like... She's probably one of the few Jedi left in the galaxy and I'm a close second. Zora's cold to the touch, and there seems to be no conventional means of opening it.
Curious thing. What lies behind it?
I mean, Atris? Atris.
Did she? Perhaps it is a meditation chamber of some sort.
I mean, all right. I guess we're gonna go. Hmm. Let's talk to this handmaiden down here, see if she can get us, Atris. If not, we're on our way.
You have returned.
I have some other questions for you. No. Never mind. Alright. We're getting out of here then. I'm assuming this is the door back to, like, the surface. Yeah. Oh, I guess I didn't need to go down this one. Whatever. It's fine. We're fine. Oh! Oh, I'm glad I came this way. Look, I would have missed some loot! The F is a Norris robe. Oh. I would like to wear some Jedi robes, but... until I'm wearing stuff that requires me to have them. There's no console in here. We're gonna go run around down here before we hop back into our ship. So we already looted that one. Oh. No, step away from the loading ramp. You see, we'll be leaving this academy for good. But the handmaiden said I was allowed to come back, so something has happened, or is going to happen. Alright, I guess we're going. I should save first, just in case. I guess we're getting on the Ebon Hawk. I am happy about this. I'm just a little concerned because it said we were leaving for good. What now?
Well, now that we're off that Dajaric board of a planet, I say we burn sky until we see lines.
What's with you, T3? I wish we got English translations for his beepy beeps, like we do with the, you did what while you were connected? Uh-oh. I hope he downloaded some stuff. Ah! The link worked both ways! Ha. That's what you get, Atris. You might. It was a holo record of the day I was exiled.
I found it.
Oh, I'm interested to see this. There's me. Why does Atris get to wear
you
all
know
white?
Why we have called you here?
I came because I chose to. No, whatever your reasons, speak them or let me go.
As Revan summoned you, so have you come full circle to return to the Jedi.
Why did you defy us? The Jedi are guardians of the peace and have been for centuries. This call to
people
war.
People were dying, and we had to stop
it. Is Revan your master now? Or is it the horror you wrought at Malachor that has caused you to see the truth at last?
No, we're gonna say the truth is the Mandalorians had to be stopped, or countless more would have died. Yeah, so you made an angry eyebrows there.
You refuse to hear us. You have shut us out, and so have shut yourself to the galaxy.
We feel that your true understanding of what happened at Malachor 5 will only happen in time, and it cannot happen here, near the battlegrounds where you fought.
You are exiled, and you are a Jedi no longer.
There is one last thing. Your lightsaber. Surrender it to us.
This is what I feel about you guys and your stupid heads. I like how it's my fault Haha.
Much defiance in that one.
Yep.
You were correct, Kavar. When she was here, I felt it. It was as if she was not there. More like an echo.
What did you
Revan's
mean by
influence
that?
Has grown amongst the youngest of the Order. She speaks to their passions, not their sense.
I mean, that sounds like Mara.
Them. Many of them have found themselves in the war against the Mandalorians.
It is as I feared. And I fear that we have played into the hands of the enemy.
We have not lost a Jedi this day. You felt it. She has lost herself. She is no Jedi. She walked Revan's path, but she was not strong enough.
I fear it is our teachings that may have led Revan to choose the path.
I agree with you, Mustache Man.
We are not the ones who taught her.
We take responsibility, Atris, not cast blame.
The choice of one was the choice of us all. Revan's teacher intended no harm, and Revan had many teachers since.
Yet they all stem from the same source. Her teachings violated the Jedi Code and lead all who listen to the dark side, as they did the Exile.
You are wrong. The dark side is not what I sensed in the Exile. Surely the rest of you felt it as well. That emptiness we felt. She has changed.
Uh-oh.
Whatever that wound was, it was of the dark side. We should not have let her depart. She will simply join Revan again, or perhaps worse.
I mean,
what would you have done with her, Atris? Be mindful of your feelings. This is not Revan who stood before you. This one walks a different path.
No, although that may come in time. We let her go because we must. Where she travels, she carries her destination with her.
Malachor V should have been her grave. You saw it in her walk and in the Force. It was as if she was already dead.
No.
Yeah, but I'm not.
Death. Many battles remain for that one, if what we have seen is true. But the future is a shifting thing.
Oh, man.
She cuts like a blade through.
They kept talking about
we
me forever after I
truth.
Left.
A Jedi deserved to know.
No good would have come from it, even if what you believe was true. There is still the matter of Revan, and such truths could leave us vulnerable on two fronts.
What?
Perhaps in many years we will call her before us and explain what happened to her, and how she may be healed. Until then, she must accept her journey.
But she may never discover the truth. And she will never know why we cast her out.
And that is the future we must accept.
Ah, oh, dicks! So there's something else going on! It's not just they were mad at me for Malachor 5, there's something else going on! So they know what happened to me, they all do. what else was in the archive? Atris had a list of all the missing Jedi if you didn't see it there. I want to know what else is there too, though. Alright, play the missing Jedi. Okay, Master Vruk. Oh, I skipped one by accident. Master Vash, Corban.
Master Atris.
I mean, well, Atris isn't missing. They were all on the council that exiled me, and now they're all missing.
There is some larger plan at work here, and we are walking into it. This is too convenient to be anything but a trap.
I mean, be that as it may, we do need their help against the Sith. We don't have much of a choice.
General? Is there a reason you don't carry a lightsaber anymore?
Did we just have this conversation about being exiled? They took it from me.
That's not your lightsaber anymore. That belonged to someone who served Revan in the wars, not the person you are now. You could build another one if you wanted to, but you know that.
I mean, I don't... Yeah. Why wouldn't I? Why wouldn't I what? I don't understand.
I don't know, General. But whatever the reason, you should put it behind you. I know this. A lightsaber is part of who you are. Without it, you're not complete.
All right, I need some parts then.
I think I can help you out there.
Beodora's gonna back me on this. We're gonna make it happen. All right, what do we need?
We need a power cell, emitter matrix, lens and focusing crystal. Though I have to admit the crystal is beyond my means. Never did understand them. Those parts are fairly common, though a Jedi once told me that it's best if your lightsaber reflects you. And if it is constructed
this is true.
With things that identify it as your own.
Yes, this is true.
Just bring the parts to me before you get started building it. I'll make sure they're usable.
Oh, jeez, we're talking to everybody now, huh?
For the last time, no.
Atten and Teeth 3 are having an argument.
Because you're programmed to force your opponent to go first. And nothing will convince me the computer doesn't cheat.
Pazak? I bet you they're arguing about Pazak.
Even if I didn't have to go first and somehow I didn't suspect you of counting cards, I still wouldn't play with a trash compactor.
Why? Hey! You'd be nice to our little dude. He's driving the ship.
Yeah? How many credits?
Did Atten lose?
Well, check it again. It can't be anything else. Just check the damn connector. I don't trust the diagnostics any more than I trust you.
Jeez!
Because I don't like droids. They break. In the head. Well, whatever you call that thing on your head. Yeah, well, if I'm mean to you, it's because I care.
What is even happening? We got all the cutscenes now.
I'm a little busy here. What is it?
Won't take more than a minute.
All right, I'll work while you talk.
Look, your friend, the Jedi, you know her from way back, don't you? How much do you know about her, really?
Her? You mean the general? Yeah, during the war. If that's what you mean by way back. Can't say I know too much about her.
Everybody's having conversations
without
me.
Better than anyone else on this ship. Just give me your opinion, okay? And don't laugh.
I'm trying to work here, Atten.
I was just wondering if you thought maybe she and I might...
Being serious.
You said you wouldn't laugh.
You are being serious. Atten, she was a general. I was just a tech. Your guess is about as good as mine.
Well, what's your guess then?
I'm getting back to work.
Hey, I'm being serious here.
Put that headband on, Atten. No one's taking you seriously. I gotta take it off of you.
You're laughing at me? I'll put you on the scrap heap, you walking tin can.
No, you won't. That's my droid.
All I'm saying is that you've gone for a long time without a memory wipe. Most droids behave
erratically. There's so many cutscenes of all of my people getting to know each other. Don't you dare memory wipe my droid!
But I'm fixing everything else around here, so I may as well take a look at you too. What was that? That's what I'm talking about. That is not normal droid behavior.
Yeah, what's going on here, guys?
I am not pushing you around. I just wanted to see if there was anything I could do to upgrade your functionality.
I mean, he probably knows what he's doing.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. Good. Now let's get started.
Good? Bad? Good?
You
bad?
Wouldn't guess it from the outside, but it looks like you've been through a lot.
Man, Beardor, you don't know the half of it. Melon doesn't know the half of it.
I'll bet. I'm all done with you. If anything comes loose, let me know and I'll put it back in place.
T3M4 has received a permanent +2 bonus to his constitution. Thank you, Beardor! Holy crap! There were so many cutscenes there! Let's save. Alright. Crafting a lightsaber. I have a fixture ready. Okay. Let's go look at the HK droid first. Because I feel like I have another part for him. Yes. Control cluster. So now we have two of the four parts. Okay, I guess we'll talk to everybody. Atten first.
Something up?
Yes. I have some questions.
All right. What did you want to know?
Where'd you get Akani training from?
Huh? What are you talking about?
Yeah, the handmaiden said that you have Akani combat training. I want to know why.
Oh, that. Don't tell anyone, but you wouldn't believe how many fights you can prevent by just pretending to know that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it doesn't compare to wearing a lightsaber, but then again, that doesn't seem to help you much.
I'm not wearing a lightsaber. I mean, don't change the subject, Atten. Come on.
Yeah? So what? I don't ask any dumb questions about your past, despite the fact that it keeps throwing us into life-threatening
situations. You pretty
situations.
Much know my past.
Want to know why? I figure if you ever want to tell me something, you will. So give me the same respect, all right?
Ooh, I'm not accusing you of anything. I just want to know if you have any other useful skills. If you have hand-to-hand combat training, you're the only one.
Well, hey, thanks. But you've got the wrong guy. I'm good at shooting people, cracking wise, and pretending to know how to fight with my hands.
All right. Whatever.
What did you want to know?
Nothing. Never mind. Butthead. So I guess what we're doing is going to all the planets that, that the Jedi Masters could be on. We're also gonna go to Telos. Back to Telos. T3, what's wrong with the astrogation system? Because we need him to run it. Why did you... He locked it? Don't tell Atlan. Atlan, I can keep my voice down. Why would you lock it? Protect who and under whose orders? Like, what are you protecting? Why didn't they want anyone to know where the ship had been? Why didn't they want anyone to know where the ship had been? The astrogation system was crippled to prevent other people learning where the Ebon Hawk had been. I mean, we knew that already, but now we know that T3 did it. How did the Ebon Hawk come back from... Oh!
T3, there's not much time. I've seen that expression on her face before. Now, I don't know where she's planning on going, but it's dangerous. She's going to leave without telling me. I don't know why, but there's a chance that she'll take you. If she does, I need you to watch out for her. She's strong, but she can't face everything alone. Do what you can, T3. If she doesn't make it back, then I need you to come back, find help. If not me, then other Jedi, the
me?
Republic.
Is she talking about
I
me?
I can't lose her, even if she wants to be lost.
Is she talking about me? No. Okay, I see. So who is the person in the hologram talking about? Dollars to donuts, it's Bastila. So I see, I'm the Obi-Wan Kenobi, and I'm your only hope. So another missing friend? Yeah, what happened to your old friend? Why aren't you with her? Since she left you. I'm sorry, T3. You decided to go for help anyway. And that's how you found me. You did help. You found us, T3. We can stop the Sith. Then there's hope after all. Yeah, doesn't tell me where the Ebon Hawk came from. I did have an epiphany and remember where the Ebon Hawk came from. I don't understand. No. Yeah, why don't you know where the Ebon Hawk came from? Like, you do have that information. You were there. Deleted. Oh, someone deleted it? Oh, he deleted it. I guess so no one could get it. That's normally why you delete things, so they're gone. You deleted it, you don't know why, and all you can show me is the hologram. Yeah, something's wrong here. There must have been a reason for it. But in deleting it, now he doesn't know why he deleted it. Yeah. You were probably just trying to protect someone, T3. It's okay. You're okay. Your heart seems to be in the right place. So I'm assuming the person in the hologram is a friend of yours. I don't understand why you hid that, though. Like, you could have just said, hey, I need your help. Here's for a lot of this time. Yeah. I understand. I didn't think you kept messages like that. I guess. Never mind. I'll be going now. school. So T3M4. Came looking for help and found me. And since then, he's been almost blown up and imprisoned and all sorts of bad things have happened to him. Kreia, you can put the sword away at any point. Woo! Did his ear spin around?
Come with questions.
I mean, I have lots of questions. Teach me more about the Force.
What is it that drives you?
I don't know. I guess Force forms?
Well. Of which did you wish instruction?
I guess not.
Ask.
I mean, this seems like a really callous thing to ask, but I'm gonna ask it. Kreia, what's wrong with your eyes?
There is nothing wrong with my sight, if that is your question. I see all that I need, though the seeing of things flesh and blood has failed me some time ago. They were distractions only.
So, can it be fixed?
There is nothing wrong with my eyes. They simply have atrophied from use. They are adequate to distinguish shapes, silhouettes. If need be, I could heal them, restore my sight. But sight can prove a distraction. When one relies on sight to perceive the world, it is like trying to stare at the galaxy through a crack in the door. But that is a lesson for another time. You must learn to see crude matter for what it is before the veil is lifted.
Can I ask you something else?
Ask, and I will answer.
Are you like a Jedi or a Sith or something?
Does it matter? Of course it does. Such titles allow you to break the galaxy into light and dark, categorize it. Perhaps I am neither. And I hold both as what they are, pieces of a whole.
Ooh, this is just a teensy bit sketchy, huh? Okay, what were you before then?
What do you wish to hear? That I once believed in the code of the Jedi? That I felt the call of the Sith, that perhaps once
I mean, the
I
truth?
Held the galaxy
the truth
by its
is a good place to start.
That for every good work that I did, I brought equal harm upon the galaxy. That perhaps what the greatest of the Sith Lords knew of evil, they learned from me. What would it matter now? There is only so much comfort in knowing such things, and it is not who I am now.
I mean, I still want to hear the story. Oh, we get a cutscene! For a minute, I thought I broke something.
There are dark places in the galaxy where few tread, ancient centers of learning, of knowledge. But I did not walk alone. To be united by hatred is a fragile alliance at best.
Crackly skin, man!
My will was not law. There were disagreements, ambition, and hunger.
And that guy! Oh shit. She was a Sith. I mean, not that we couldn't suspect that already, but she was a Sith.
There are techniques within the Force against which there is no defense.
Do I want to know what they did to her? Oh, goodness. Oh, goodness. Oh, my God. He's not even, like, using the Force against her. He's just beat her up.
Stripped of my power. Exile.
Like me.
I suffered indignities.
Now I understand. She's projecting so hard.
My mistakes, and use that knowledge to become greater than I. That is all I ask of you, and that is all I desire. In you, all my hopes rest for the future, for the Force.
Whoa. I mean, I don't feel like I need more than that, but if she's willing to tell me more, I'm willing to hear it.
If it means so much to you, then this I swear to you upon my life. Upon our lives, that when your training is complete, I will answer everything. There shall be no more shadows between us, only truth that exists between master and apprentice.
All right, I guess that's good enough for now.
And I will answer.
No. Do you know Atris?
I know her as much as I know any Jedi. If you have other questions, you may ask those, but on Atris,
influence failure.
I can provide you no answers that you cannot find on your own.
Well, let's do this. Did I get any influence points? No.
Yes.
Let's try again. I do have some questions. Atris. Okay. Never mind. Next time we get influence with Kreia, remind me to ask her about Atris. It's the lock panel. We did that already, right? Or at least tried to find it. Yeah, we did that already. This is the engine room. We already talked to Atten. We should go talk to Baldur.
Hey, General. Are you all right?
I guess so. Do I seem not all right?
You look like you've been standing too close to one of my shield generators.
I guess you're one to talk.
Whoa. Claws out.
Whoa!
Today,
I didn't mean that. Nasty? Yeah.
Seriously, you don't look that way from spending extra time in the fresher. I've seen other Jedi. Not many, but a few who look like that. And I feel a little strange around you. A little more in control. Calm. Like I usually only get.
Awesome. I have a calming effect on people. I mean, it's kind of a Jedi thing, so...
If you don't want to talk about it, I won't press you.
No.
Was this something you wanted me
to... I didn't mind talking about it. Where did you get that little remote, dude?
That old thing? I built him when I was a kid. Been following me around for years now, despite what I've done to try and chase him off. Hey, just kidding. I'm happy to have you around.
Does it do anything?
He helps me out with repairs. I outfitted him with a cutting laser and some other tools for delicate modifications.
Cool.
He's also good for singeing the pants of annoying techs.
He should hang out with T3.
I've been thinking about doing some other work on him, but I barely have time. Too busy fixing up the ship. Something else I can help you with?
Is this insensitive?
I got tired of it. Kept dropping my hydro spanner. Figured I'd get a new one.
I bet that was fun.
I was only kidding. Actually, it was a souvenir from Malachor. I was lucky it was all I lost. Hmm. But at least it gave me something to do, right? Everyone always said I was probably half machine anyway.
I mean,
something
okay.
else I can help you with.
What do you think about Telos?
If the Republic would just rein Zerka in, there'd be no problem. But as long as Zerka is allowed to undermine
I'm
the
glad
Authorian's
he agrees.
Efforts, Telos will remain dead. I can't take seeing my work being used by those bloodsuckers. But there's nothing I can do about it, so let's talk about something else.
Okay, do you have any shields I could use?
Sure do, General. I made a few while I wasn't working on the ship.
That's way better than stims from Candorous.
The best shield is not getting shot at all.
I mean,
something
I'm aware.
I can help you with?
What you doing?
Just working on the ship. I'm not sure who got her up and running, but I'm amazed she's even space-worthy. Whoever made these repairs doesn't think like most mechanics. But don't worry, I'll get everything in shape.
Cool, and we got an energy shield and a Mandalorian melee shield. I mean, that's everyone. They have a pretty small crew right now. So what I'm gonna do is run back up to the galaxy map, and we're landing back at Telos. Why are we landing back at Telos? To go tell Lieutenant Grell that, yeah, we found your criminals, they're dead. Give me my bounty money. Also, I'd like to see if anything else has changed. The tiny little green area and the rest of the planet's just messed right up. We can skip this cutscene. We've seen it before. Alright. A little map in the middle there. That's nice. And let's get off the ship. We are going to bring Beodor and T3. Yes. Yes, I'm sure. Really, I'm a little sick of hearing Kreia and Atten complain to each other. Also, this is a thing. Auto level. Yes, from 7 to 11. Now we need to re-outfit him. Let's put... 2... Let's see, plus 2, repair, shock arm, I like. Ion blast arm, yes, did that already. Deflector mark 3, energy collector, what? I know, I'm pressing wrong buttons. What's the energy collector? Absorbs it? And it must be replaced regularly. Okay, well, we'll stay where we are with that for now. Oh, you don't need a mining laser. You can have a ion blaster. For now, yes. We still have the modified holdout pistol, but whatever. We're not using it right now. Let's go talk to Lieutenant Grell. It was Grell, right? Show him we got our ship back on our own. Okay, so this looks like a bad thing.
Unnecessary observation. Targets acquired.
Oh, for real?
Recitation. Let us proceed to facilitate communications. Recitation. And bring about the termination of hostilities.
Well, that didn't really work. Oh, where's my... I have been de-equipped. Trandosan, sure. No, I was using the Gamorrean cleaver. I did not expect to get into a fight with droids here. Oh, I'm so almost dead. I don't have an energy shield equipped either. Jeez. Heal, please. Oh, I'm not gonna heal myself. Nope. Oh, this is gonna be... This is gonna be bad. I'm gonna get over here. Stop. What the hell is even happening? I should have guessed that as soon as we landed. I just forgot that they were assassin droids after me last time. Oh, yeah. Down she goes. One of these is a droid blaster thing. Oh, no. Okay. This is... If we die here, I'm sorry, but I was not prepared for this. Oh no, Beodor's dead now too. System's failing, Master. Okay, I need to use... Do I have repair kits? Advanced repair kit. Oh, thank goodness. Get him! Get him some more! Keep getting him! Oh, for peace sakes, T3M4 saved our lives. Oh. That was, let's save, that was not a good time. Oh, there's the, HK chassis. Hopefully the HK droid that we're about to reassemble doesn't go all crazy on us. Hi, Chihuahua. That was not a good time. Well, they're still there. We need to go to, yeah, the entertainment dock. Alright, let's heal. And over to the police station. No, I don't want to talk to Batono.
I don't have anything for you, but
I don't want to talk to Batono. Yep. Yeah, are you not going to arrest me for something?
I was disturbed that you chose to defy our orders and obtain transport off Citadel Station.
I mean, you did tell me not to leave, so...
The matter has since been closed. It was the decision of Republic authorities that your testimony would no longer be necessary.
Oh.
And thus you'd be allowed to go.
Excellent.
But as we discovered, you had already left. In some ways, it was lucky for us, avoiding a possibly embarrassing situation.
Why did they change their mind?
Why
that seems awfully fishy.
The head doesn't know what the feet are doing. The hands don't even know they've got fingers, let alone where they are.
Oh, okay.
Opinion, they probably performed their independent investigation and figured it wasn't your fault. Anyways, you should just be glad I decided to overlook the fact.
Excuse me? You really should improve your security arrangements.
Yeah, yeah. And if there's nothing else, I've got a job to do.
There is something else.
What is it? I see.
I killed the criminals.
And where and when did you kill them?
On the surface of Telos. They were on duty as Zerka security.
I see. Well, you certainly earned the bounty on those two dangerous criminals. Here it is. I think you'll find the amount more than adequate. The TSF once again thanks you for your cooperation.
200 credits. That's it. Gren. That's his name. Lieutenant Gren. All right. Dinks. I think that's all we had to do on here. I'm not smuggling. Not smuggling. Let's get back down. Let's get back down to the docks. All right. So while I run back to the docking bay and get back on the Ebon Hawk, I think I'm actually going to leave this one here for now. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Wenchfaery. Please don't forget to click the like button and subscribe if you haven't already. This has been Knights of the Old Republic 2, The Sith Lords, and we will see you next time.